This new strat is gonna decimate the old record time. Fire. Usually I'd release the brake, but there's no need to release the brake. Because I'm just testing out strats. And that's not one of them. That to happen. I'm actually just gonna stop. Ooh, I took too much damage. Yeah, this is ridiculous. Second boost. Alright, it only works on a red line. That's good. That's good to know. this because I can. I got free time. Oh shit, maybe I don't. Ah, it's sloppy. Sloppy, sloppy, sloppy. Strat calls me to push some shit out of the way so I can grab that. But I don't need to do that anymore. I think I'm going to be okay. I think I would, if I was doing time right now, I'd be about, I don't know, 3 minutes, maybe, maybe more ahead. Next up is the radio. I should be able to get to the radio pretty quickly. Downhills is great. This defense. I'm actually gonna tap this, come up here, drop it. Just regular. Maybe a way to do that better. Thank you. Very nice. Very nice. I would love to know where I'm at. Time-wise. I don't think I'm gonna get to complete the game unless we're past it. Didn't anticipate doing a full run right here. I gotta drop those on the hooks. That's the way to do it. Usually take the damage here. Actually, I'll be fine. Unless I catch fire randomly. Still need a sail here, so we won't forget to put the sail up next time. Oh shit. This is a huge time loss. If I was really worried right now. Missed it. Oh, insult to injury. I can't do it anymore because up here is where I have to stop anyway. I Really? I can't even get up the hill? That's weird. Sheesh. It took way more effort than I thought it should. Light years away from where I would be right now. Let me see if I can finish the run out. Just do a timing afterwards. This little sub here works off this box up top. It doesn't work off where the position of that vehicle is. So if you can, it's like a little way you can jump into the box so that it starts moving quicker. I got it. And you'll see that the sub breaks before the vehicle gets there, which allows this thing to come down and I can get in. Get in early. What's messed up about it? Is it just blurry or whatever? Didn't mean to touch that. That's actually really bad. Oh, I don't, maybe. I'm still, fidgeting with things to try to get proper alignments and whatnot. If it's messed up, just let me know. I can, try to adjust it. I think it's because I wasn't able to size it up by aspect ratio, because I wanted it to fit in that hole better. So it just kind of distorted it. It's a timer, right? It counts your splits. I have it turned off right now because I didn't plan on doing a full run. But it's so that you can time each section of the game, basically, so you can know where you're saving time, where you're losing time, if it was better or worse this time than last time. So hopefully I get to this flat plane area before I can show you a little speed boost here. I missed it. So the theory here, well, the theory it works, I just have to not be stupid, is that if I wait for that to pop out all the way on a red line boost, hit it, when it pops out quickly, jump over, hit steam, not jump again, you can see how the red line goes up. You get a massive speed boost that way. In fact, I'm not used to it, so I've run into a couple things that I didn't mean to. But hit the button, stop time for a minute. Yeah, so you have to hit the button yourself. So it's not too much of a burden. It kind of is sometimes, but you know, just another finger movement. So I'm gonna have to retime this video at the end. I don't plan on submitting it for any kind of record, because I want to optimize first. Oops. But I just want to see where I'm at time-wise. So I did a pretty good run with 111. Still room for improvement, obviously, but that was without doing that trick the whole time. So I just want to see where that puts me if I do it as much as possible. Already it's been amazing, because I was able to, from when you first jump into the vehicle, I was actually able to only stop at the third resupply with the red drum, and just grab that one red drum and still make it all the way to sales, you know, and further. So I actually haven't had an issue with fuel this whole time, which has been pretty phenomenal. So I can already imagine saving minutes, you know, having to stop, get out, get it, put it in, load it, do, you know, XYZ. As far as the fluidness of it goes, though, it's definitely been kind of a shady run. Missing jumps and missing barrels and doing that. But it's cool. So I've already been, let's see, my uptime for streaming is 34 minutes. If I turn my splits on here for a second, I can tell you where I should be at this time. But give me a second to get everything set up. Let's grab this. So what I have noticed is it doesn't work too well going uphill. So that's an issue. So let's do this. So we're at, we got repair. Oh, I missed it. I'm looking at my other timer. Twister, sub, winch, build the future. We should be here. So my stream uptime is 34 minutes, which, you know, was me setting stuff up and everything still. I'm still 5 minutes ahead of where I should be. I'm not going to try to boost it here. Actually, you know what? I will try to boost it here. There's a lot of obstacles in the way, it may not work. Usually I'd be pounding these things out of the way. Steaming every chance I got. Yeah, it's not. Actually, let me see if this might help anything. I'm kind of broken. Might just be one of those ones that's a little faster just to do it and push through everything quickly. Missed it. That's all right, 'cause I was coming down here anyway. But I had to slam on the brakes. I sometimes do. Right now I'm good on fuel. Just turn it off in this segment here would have just taken extra time away than I needed to set up other things. I'm pretty sure once I get super optimized, I'll be able to find holes that I haven't been able to see recently. But yeah, it is sucking fuel. It is wasting fuel, but I don't want to get to a point where I turn it off and forget to turn it back on. Because it is my main source of collecting fuel. Because, you know, I don't have to stop now to pick up stuff. So we did that. Main power, that's what we're doing. Our manpower, sorry, we're doing now. New wheels would be next. So that would have been that. So at 43 minutes, I should be on my way moving after I put on the wheels. Yeah, it definitely can hurt you. There's certain areas where you want to turn it off because of, you know, you will run out of fuel. It's a huge waste. Oh, jeez. But I've been alright right now with where it's at. Come in here. See, in here I'll turn it off. I don't need this next fuel canister. Actually, I'll pick up the next fuel canister and turn it off once I get past it. I don't need any fuel in here. It's just a waste of time to have it on. Bounce over this one. And then you want to hit that. See before so faster, yeah. So when I start again, I'm gonna want to turn it on because there are those fuel cans right there that I need. But so far we're good. We're not wasting a lot of fuel either because everything's moving. So oh Jesus. We're not wasting fuel because we're moving so much faster now to get point A to point B. It doesn't waste any more fuel to go fast. So that's actually really good for us. But that button is finicky. And 1, 2, 3, go. There we go. It'd be cool if it would suck you up. Yeah, you're right. Fast away into the thing. Maybe shot you across the vessel once you got inside. Oh, I was gonna miss that. Yeah, so if my stream uptime is less than my current counter, you have to imagine that I'm probably 2, 3, maybe 4 minutes even ahead of that. Oh, I didn't need to do that. Oops. A couple seconds wasted. No big deal. Right? Yeah. Thank you. right now. But I will need it for the next section. Come on. Damn. Also, the boost uphills. It seems to be finicky. I've got it to work a couple times, but it seems to be a lot more finicky than on flatland or downhill. Downhill seems to be the best. Maybe it doesn't have to do with me hitting this button again. Maybe it's just popping it. Sometimes messes up when it takes the fuel up, so it'll stutter, just like the switch does to go, like if it gets damaged, it'll stutter on you. I didn't need that. I got plenty of fuel, I'm just gonna leave it alone. I'm gonna push this in, I'm gonna try something here. That's what testing strats is all about. And build up steam. Start moving immediately. And that way I can get this boost off as soon as I can. Just like that. Very nicely done for me. And look at it, it just keeps going up too. See? Just keeps still going up. I'm still getting faster. Still getting faster. Jesus. I don't think I've ever seen it. Maybe it works off how long I hold down the right arrow key. Because I'm pegging this thing right now. I need to go get some fuel. Jesus, broken. Look at that thing. No, I haven't even tried to get the 9001. I'm max. Look at that. That's crazy. Still going at max speed. Let me hit this wall here. Yep, so you have to have at least a half a tank of steam built up. Or you will not break through that wall, even after you hit it. So I gotta sit here now and just waste all this time. Ooh, maybe I got a red line in. I always thought it was a half a tank. into this wall here. That's what I think happened. Usually you can hit that wall, you can peg it, and then hit a steam boost right when you hit it, or right after you hit it, and it'll do a second bust, like it'll bust the gate open. But this time it doesn't seem like it wanted to work. No, this is the right spot. This isn't where you jump over the gate. I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna have to reload. Yeah, this is, nice. Good thing I wasn't timing this for, speedrun purposes. Why the fire bus? So, they are a last resort, right? So if you run out of full fuel completely and you have one, it'll give you 100%. tax fuel, but at the cost of damaging your engine and damaging your fuel tank. So it's kind of a, you know, do you do it, do you risk it kind of thing. That's what should have happened. You just hit it nice and easy. Steam right when you hit it, you bust through. Here's the hail section that everybody hates to talk to. I'm gonna attempt to obviously just push through this thing. Before my engine gets damaged. Let's see if I can hold this speed. This is just stupid, bro. It's not even a playing the challenge. Fire again? No fire. Cool. Nice. Oh, this game is broken now. Yeah, I can see a sub 1 hour time frame, guaranteed. Absolutely, 47 minutes in, and let's see, I should be at new boat, sailboat, ramming speed, hail. Yeah, metal crafting is my next split at 50 minutes. I've been streaming for 47. So, you know, I'm already 5 minutes ahead, I guess. As long as you put the fires out, you can leave everything damaged up there from the hail. It's completely okay, because this next section you have nothing but time to just sit there. So if I get this to catch, I did. Very good. You need to stop the minecart. Okay. Didn't know that. You can just jump up there? That's just an easy one jump? Oops. I didn't think I reached that. Or maybe just jump off the top while it's still moving. Is that what you're saying? I leave those there because I can just come pick it up with the thing. I reloaded here because of the stupid elevator and my mailbox was on the other side. Okay. Why was your mailbox on the other side? So everything's damaged now, so what you do here is you just take the damage again, no big deal. You're gonna run this in, like, block it. Cool. Now you're just gonna fix everything. It'll run itself right into the holes that it needs to go in. What is it? I ran out of fuel. That's a problem. Oh, I missed that. Huh. Okay, next time I'll go. So do it and hit steam. One batch of steam. Oh my god. Get my way. I was worrying, is this the end? Okay. That makes sense now. So again, start this up early. Build some steam. Get some movement as soon as these things drop. Oh, yep, missed that one. So we got plenty of fuel inside of this drum. So again, we're gonna try to hit this. Here we go. I'm gonna hold it again and see if I can keep this speed up. Uphill. So as soon as you switch terrain, it looks like it messes it up. But that's alright. I don't think I'm gonna catch it this time. I got it. That's the uphill version. You speed a little bit. I think there's a wind. Yep, there's one right here. Pop this out. Just because I don't think I need it. So this. Speed boost. Yeah, that next notch. Okay, so it did reset the speed. Good. I gotta get all the shit out. Just moving across this plane right now. So that's good. Actually, you know what? That's kind of stupid of me. It's kind of stupid. I could have just left it actually in the suction tube. At this speed I'm going, I won't need as much fuel. Right? So I can just, if I keep everything stored in there, then I can. Oh, I missed it. If I keep everything stored in there, then. Snow, so we're at 5322 where we should be. And we've only been streaming for 52 minutes. There we go. Yeah. Beautiful speed. Yeah, hills really affect your speed. We'll pop both of those. Didn't need to. Set it here. Actually, I don't even need to. I should have closed this when I hit this bridge. Because we got this thing coming up. I'm going to run into this truck at full speed. Reset this. Put some gas in here. Push it off. Oh my god. 1 centimeter, so steam it next time. Sorry, I'm trying to read and play, so it looks like you can hold 3 items, one on top. Yeah, that's perfect. Especially if I'm moving this fast. This took me probably 10 minutes. Right? It's coming, like, there's a little drip that you can barely see, kind of, on that thing, and as the cog moves, the door opens a little bit. So, I'm gonna come back over here and do the same thing, because this is over. I'm gonna boost myself up here. Come up here, I'm gonna set my sail up. I can't remember if I need my sail in this next area or not. I'm not using my splits, so I can't. Oh, I'm out of fuel. Shit. Look, that's, there you go. Downside of, using that all the time. Wasn't even paying attention. Give me 1 second, I gotta get the door. I don't think it might not be necessary on this part. Looks like I'm getting a good speed boost anyway. I'm getting max. Yeah, that's max speed right there. I'm gonna have to stop here. super early. I'm not used to driving this fast in this part. But you gotta release the brake. There we go. I wish there was a way to release the brake, you know, remotely. No intentions of this being a full run until I started seeing this was possible of doing. So this is actually railway maintenance. Yeah, once I get done with this, even with the pauses and the reset, you know, the load or whatever, I think I'm still going to be under my current best time. Wait for the kids to go to sleep tonight and do it for real run. So you can probably jump on this just until, that's what I do, is just until it comes over top of this red switch. And I walk over. I could have done two more, like one or two more jumps. That switch late too. Oh, by the way, I didn't mean to do that. But by the way, if you're trying to go too fast, you can actually jump inside the fuel tank. Just completely wrecks you. Oh gosh. I'm so focused on trying to get this speed now, I'm not even paying attention to where my energy's at or anything else. It's alright, this little segment here is pretty short. I might get one speed boost in. I'm gonna wreck the mast going into this next building. Yeah, so so the energy button, right? I'm gonna hit this. Oh my god, that was beautiful. I'm still, look at my tires. I broke them. They're still spinning. Look at that. They're broken. That's hilarious. Take this upstairs with me. Oh my god. That was poorly executed. Is that too quick? This with you over here so you can skip this part.
shouldn't be asking these telephone questions. So again, we're gonna hit this at full speed. I don't usually come over here. Yep, and I missed it. So if you do a full push in right here, you hit it with just the right amount of steam to break through immediately. And then you come down here, and you don't actually have to do this because I want that barrel, and now I'm not going to get it. So that barrel is important because it allows me to. I can't get to it. So usually what'll happen is you come underneath, or not even go underneath, you just set the barrel up and then you can pull it over here and jump off of it to land on top of this. So that goes down and saves, like, you know, 4 seconds. Come down here early. Doesn't matter because you can't do anything with this barrel but put it into position. Quick way to move this. I wish there was. Oh my god, there's a quick way to move it. I've tried pushing that thing like that 100 times. Never worked. You come over here. Hit the button for the first one, and then you'll already be set up for the second one completely. Oh my god, I'm an idiot. come up and winch it. Got ahead of myself. Rip. So maybe that'll help, I don't know. It does this weird thing if you try to, like, lift it up too early, where it actually will get stuck. It'll get stuck, and then the winch will actually somehow, like, teleport through the map and, like, go underneath the walker, so it gets stuck completely, so you have to actually release it, drop the box, and reset it. Kinda, but it's fine. I'm not doing a time run right now. I enjoyed the conversation. When I was doing this last night, I was, you know, talking to myself the entire time, so now at least I have a reason to be speaking. You don't even need a boost down here. No, the stream can't do that. It can't blow things up. Because you're already going to be at max speed this entire time through this process. There's no reason to even try to boost it. Behind you, which actually sets up for the next point, where this is a not a timed evolution right here, but a specific point evolution where you have to go this slow until you get a certain distance past this rock. So you can save, you know, 5-10 seconds or so before you can get to this point where you start slow rolling and you start the balancing act. Issues with running out of fuel or missing boosts. I think this is I think we could do pretty good. Get a really good time. Streaming now, so I can download this video and actually see what my official time was. So, appreciate you sitting in here, buddy, listening to my ramblings.